Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And I'm making this video with WPExplorer.com, the makers of the Total theme. It's a pretty total theme. It's pretty awesome theme. And this video is going to go with a series of videos on something called AMP. And what that stands for is Accelerated Mobile Pages. And hey guys, whether you know it or not, this is something you're gonna have to deal with for the 2017, and the sooner you do it, the better. And what AMP is it's a Google thing. Now, Google has a tendency to force technologies or ways of doing things down our throats, because after all, don't we want Google to favor our website? So if we do want Google to favor our website and show it when people are searching for things related to our website, we've got to play by Google's rules. And there's a couple big things coming down the pike with that. Number one, and this video is not about it, but I'm going to throw it in, and that is adding an SSL certificate on your website. You're going to get penalized in 2017 if you don't have that. But this video is about AMP, and that means Accelerated Mobile Pages. Essentially, what Google wants you to do is have a version of all of the pages on your website that when someone is going to your website from a mobile device, through Google, it will show this other version of the page that has a lot of the things that will slow your page down. It has it all stripped out. So it kind of strips out all of the bloat. And in Google's mind, it's about giving Google searchers the fastest version of your website. And there's a good reason for that, because one of the biggest Google SEO search ranking parameters is bounce rate. And what bounce rate is when someone clicks through to your website, if they're sitting there and it takes forever for your page to load, what are they going to do? They're going to hit back. They're going to bounce back to Google. Well, Google is measuring that. And if you have a high bounce rate, it's not good for you. They're going to say, okay, this page has a high bounce rate. Let's not show this to people anymore because there's something wrong with the page. The content is incorrect. There's something wrong with it. So what they do over time is your page goes down and down and down in the search engine rankings that you want. So let me just try to show you as best as I can in a video this AMP thing, Accelerated Mobile Pages. So what I have right here is Google. And I have it opened up, and my web browser has a really cool mode where I can see web pages as if they were certain devices. So this is Google thinking I'm on an iPhone Plus right now. So let's search here. Why don't we search for something I know is in the news right now, the US election. And when I do that search, it's going to show me the results of the election, but that's not why I'm doing it. And so you can see their top stories here. The first one's the Guardian, and the second one's from BBC News. But what is different? And it's this little thing right here. It says AMP. And right here it says AMP. Now you might have noticed this already when you're on your mobile device, this acronym AMP, which stands for Accelerated Mobile Pages. And when I scroll down on some of the normal results that come when you search, there it is again, AMP, AMP. It's letting you know that this is an accelerated mobile page. And what that's going to start communicating to people that are searching in your result of your websites there, if you have AMP, they're going to think, if I click on that, I'm going to get to see the content like that. A normal website load time could be from 1 to 5 seconds. A slow website could be a lot higher than that. Your AMP pages will load in a second or less. And so that AMP, people are going to start noticing that. Now, right now, Google's not using AMP as a ranking factor, they say. But coming up next year, guaranteed AMP is going to be a ranking factor when Google's going to decide what pages to show someone when they're searching on a mobile device. So when you click through an AMP page, it's going to strip out a lot of the junk that is in a web page because it's made specifically for a mobile device. So let me scroll down. I'm going to click right here on this AMP page, and it just pops up immediately. And it looks beautiful, and it's about delivering beautiful page content at lightning fast speeds. So now you might be thinking, this is great, but it sounds awfully complicated to implement. But the good news is it's not that complicated to implement on your website. And this video is actually the first video in a short series about AMP pages. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to implement AMP on your WordPress-based website. And this video was just more to serve as an overview of AMP, why you need it, the benefits of it for you, and in the next video, I will show you how to implement it. Hey, before you go, I have something for you, and before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.